DET, the heart of Texas. Bally Sports Southwest, the heart of the fan.
After a rare Sunday off, the Stars are ready to begin a brand new week, and it has all the makings of an enormous one. Riding a season-long point streak, Dallas has played themselves to the cusp of a playoff spot and hopes to stay hot as they take aim on the same opponent four straight times. Meanwhile, the two teams they're racing in the standings will play three games against each other. The Stars will have to win to keep pace, but at the same time, they could also make up ground. With little time left this season, it's moving week in the Central, and the Stars are looking to hit the gas. Stars Hockey is presented by Choctaw Casinos and Resorts. The final two legs of the Stars homestand make up the first half of a four-game week against the Detroit Red Wings. And with 3 weeks to go in the regular season, things are tight in the Central. The Stars are 3 points out of a playoff spot with three games in hand. And the two teams that they're trying to catch, Nashville and Chicago, they go head-to-head tonight, Wednesday, and Friday, making for a very important stretch of games. Hi there, everybody, and a very good evening to you. Welcome to Dallas Stars Hockey alongside Daryl Ray. I'm Josh Bogorod. We are late in the hockey season, Razor. That's an entertaining time. Maybe it's a stressful time, but it's the perfect time for the Stars to be playing what's probably their best stretch of hockey.
Yeah, they're off to a rousing start here in the final full month of the regular season, and especially here at home. They're 6-2-2 in the month of April. The best record in the division in that span, spiffy goal differential, strong special teams, and goaltending along the way. And the top two lines have really paced the homestand so far. After going 10 games without a goal, Joe Pavelski has scored in three straight games, going each of those pastings of the Columbus Blue Jackets here, and then provided the tying goal in the contest against the Florida Panthers to get him to OT. Denis Gurianov has emerged from a 2.5 month bunk. 3 goals in the last 2 games for Denis. 5 points all told. He seems to be finding his stride at the most opportune time of the year. Rookie Jason Robertson has done his work all season long, it feels like. Scored his 8th goal in a 12-game span during this homestead. He has 5 points in the 3 games. And the captain, Jamie Benn, has played his best hockey of the season since being shifted to center ice. Pretty slick tally last game. He's +7 in the first 3 games of this homestand. The impressive thing to me is that all of this offensive damage has been done at even strength. Usually it's the power play that powers them, but not this homestand.
The Stars have not seen the Detroit Red Wings in a month. They've played them 4 times all season. They're going to double that in the next 6 nights starting here tonight. So, Razors, they get ready for a whole lot of Red Wings. What's the book on Detroit?
Well, it looks like, especially lately, they're either locked tight defensively or real leaky. And when they win, they don't give up all that much. They've allowed a single goal in 5 of their past 6 wins. But they've also surrendered 7 goals 5 times this season, including the last time here in this building. Joe Pavelski opened the scoring. Always seems like Joe shows up in the goal-scoring highlights, especially in this building. Scored a first-period goal there, the big pump. In the second, Cogliano, a hard-working dig-in goal in front of the net. Gurianov made it 3-1 and knocked Bernier from the game, their starting netminder. And then in the third period, they went berserk. Alexiak, little seeing eye wrister from the blue line. Ty Delandry on the power play, his first ever National Hockey League goal. Dowling ended up scoring an empty netter. You think that's it, right? That's the end of the night. Nope. John Klingberg, little insult with 1.5 minutes to go as they capitulated in a 7-3 final.
Up next, we focus in on two guys who have found the net consistently of late. Rope Hintz and Adam Ernie take center stage in our marquee matchup right after this.
The master knows what